Greetings, 565 here. You may have read the title and thought, why is a game developer saying game development sucks? Because it's so slow. It is just so slow to make a game. It takes years to create games. Because they're complex creations, they combine multiple different disciplines into an interactive experience unlike any other medium. This takes a lot of time, especially as a hobbyist indie developer without a team of specialized creatives to help me. If there's anything I've learned, it's well worth taking the time to do something now that seems slow to prevent issues in the future. For me, that's documenting my work in my upcoming game, High Velocity Arena. When I document my work, it forces me to plan and it forces me to think about my code beyond its obvious purpose. I understand what the code does, but why does it work? How should it be written to best fit in with the rest of the code? Or what's most relevant to this video, how and why does this code break? This single line of code, process world state, seems innocent enough, but it has caused a ton of headache for me. Within this function, it does something called client reconciliation or client prediction, depending on who you ask. Every time new information from the game is received from the server, the player teleports to where the server says it should be. Then every input you've put in since where the server says you are gets replayed, meaning in a perfect situation, you end up in the same position you were in before. There is an article by Valve in the description if that doesn't make sense and you need it explained differently. Knowing how I've scripted everything, this code reconciles all input up until this point, then passes new input to the player, then the player executes this input. But with the world state at the end, the code should take the new input, then reconcile it, then the player executes it, which is an issue because that means the reconciliation script is working with input that the player hasn't actually acted on yet. This, in theory, should cause the player to move on a single input twice. So I switched the code around and the gameplay still looked the same. So I dug around and did hours of debugging only to find that the output log looked the same. Yes, when the input and reconciliation happened, it was shifted by a tick, but the data looked right and the gameplay just felt fine. It didn't make any sense that code that was clearly different was giving me the same output. So I decided to test both the scripts when the player started from standstill. And wouldn't you know it, the world state call being after the input did cause the input to be run twice, only in the beginning. The very nature of the reconciliation function effectively smoothed this initial double processing, resulting in the one tick difference I showed earlier. I understood there was a difference, and while I obviously at this point settled on my original code, you know, the one that didn't replay inputs twice, I still needed to know why this mattered. So what if it ran twice if the end result was the same? I need to really understand the effects of the code. Assuming the reconciliation occurs perfectly, there should be no difference between the velocity beforehand and the velocity afterwards. So I found out that putting the world state beforehand consistently results in a velocity delta of zero. Putting the world state afterwards did not, which is objectively bad. More errors means more correction needs to be done by the server, which feels worse and is ultimately just bad netcode. With such solid evidence in hand, I confidently placed the world state before the input processing and moved on. This is why good game development takes a while. Some people may deem this whole level of perfectionistic scrutiny as unnecessary, but I view it as a wholly necessary part of game development. A developer who doesn't really grasp what he's doing is like a baker throwing stuff together because he thinks it'll make a good cake. It won't. And while my game is taking a long time to develop, I'm confident it will do solidly on release because I'm confident the game has been crafted with care on every aspect. I don't want a single facet to be rough and unpolished, especially the netcode, which is arguably the most important part of a multiplayer game. Go wishlist High Velocity Arena on Steam at 565.dev/HVA. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.